I'm Steve Kirsch. I'm executive director of the COVID-19 Early Treatment Fund. I have no conflicts. Advance to slide number 4 with the elephant. I'm going to focus my remarks today on the elephant in the room that nobody likes to talk about, that the vaccines kill more people than they save. Today, we focus almost exclusively on COVID death saves and vaccine efficacy because we were led to believe that the vaccines are perfectly safe. But this is simply not true. For example, there were 4 times as many heart attacks in the treatment group in the Pfizer 6-month trial report. That wasn't bad luck. Theirs shows heart attacks happen 71 times more often following these vaccines compared to any other vaccine. In all, 20 people died who got the drug, 14 died who got the placebo. Few people noticed that. If the net all-cause mortality from the vaccines is negative, vaccines, boosters, and mandates are all nonsensical. This is the case today. Death rates. Let's slide number 7 advance to the number 7 in lower part. This shows that the all-cause death light rate in 3 cases. Only the VAERS numbers are statistically significant, but the other numbers are troubling. Even if the vaccines had 100% protection, it still means we kill 2 people to save 1 life. 4 experts did analyses using completely different non-US data sources, and all of them came up with approximately the same number of excess vaccine-related deaths, about 411 deaths per million doses. That translates into 150,000 people have died. Next slide would be slide number 11, the nursing home. Now, the real numbers confirm that we kill more than we save. And I would love everyone to look at the Israel Ministry of Health data on the 90-plus-year-olds, where we went from a 94.4% vaccinated group to 82.9% vaccinated in the last 4 months. In the most optimistic scenario, it means that 50% of the vaccinated people died and 0% of unvaccinated people died. Unless you can explain that to the American public, you cannot approve the boosters. Slide number 16, please, myocarditis. The paper just posted yesterday on MedArchive entitled mRNA COVID-19 Vaccination and Development of CMR Confirmed Myopericarditis shows that the myopericarditis risk was 1 in 1,000, and that's an overall age range from 18 to 65, mean age of 33. It is not inconsistent with what the VAERS shows. Next slide would be slide number 18, gaming of the trial. It's pretty clear that the Pfizer trial results were gamed. It's statistically impossible for protocol violations to be 5 times higher in the treatment group. Why hasn't this been investigated? Slide number 19. Maddie DeGray was 12 when she enrolled in the Pfizer phase 3 trial for kids. Now she's paralyzed for life. It wasn't reported by it in the Pfizer results. I told Janet Woodcock there was no investigation. Please tell us why this fraud was not investigated. And finally, slide number 20, please. Early treatments are a much better alternative to boosters. The proof is that in Israel, cases are at an all-time high. In India, Uttar Pradesh is now COVID-19 free as of today. Almost nobody there is vaccinated. Thank you.